My name is Hannah van Loo, psychiatrist.
My name is Panos Mercouris. I'm a professor of international law and a lawyer.
Julia Costa Lopez, assistant professor of history and theory of international relations.
I'm Diederik Roest and I'm a theoretical physicist and a cosmologist.
My name is Marijke Redeveld, assistant professor at the Department of Marketing.
Well, hello. My name is Tom Spitz and I'm a video and education expert at Educational Support and Innovation. What you just saw were fragments of your own Young Academy introduction videos, which were part of our inspiration for this workshop on how to create a research profile video that stands out. During this workshop, me and my video team will support you in shaping your video profile. But first, why do you need a video profile? With an online text-based profile, which I advise you also to have, people can still get the information. But a video gives a face and voice to who you are, so you can show better what you stand for and that you can get across a message in a pleasant way to an audience. Also, in this visual age, a short video seems to be more appealing and easier to share with a larger audience. Second, what is the purpose of your video? It may be for valorization, where you want to reach out to a larger audience and share your findings or expertise. Or like the YAH introductions, it's more an introduction to colleagues to make you more recognizable and approachable. Or you would like to use it as a showcase for yourself with a career perspective in mind. In that case, your target audience may be more senior academics in and outside your own university. In all cases, it is important that your story connects. You create a hook to pique the interest of the audience. Let's examine how this can be done.
And yet, what this tells us is that how we think that people are similar or different has greatly varied throughout history.
Julia Costa Lopez has a great hook here, but unfortunately, it took her 37 seconds to get to it, which is quite a while for video. Let's examine another example that did this better.
Instant yeast. I'm sure you used it to bake bread. But did you also know that this powder is a microorganism that can be genetically manipulated?
Sonja Billerbeck immediately grabs your attention with something we recognize, the yeast, but also sets up a question about something we did not know and promises us that she will tell more. This question-based approach is a powerful hook that keeps an audience invested. Susanna Faber from University of Utrecht has another layer to this, relevance. And that she explains her research in relation to being based on a local Utrecht problem.
Did you know that right underneath us here in the Griftpark, there are bacteria in the subsoil eating away contamination?
Finally, Jan-Willem Bolderdijk's video adds an extra dimension, visual support.
83% of the world population cares about sustainability. Yet, our carbon footprint is increasing and increasing. We fly across the world for holidays, and we still include red meat in our daily diet. So how is it possible that people say they care so much about sustainability and at the same time fail to act accordingly?
Besides using questions to trigger our interest, he's even managed to make the background relevant by showing a burger restaurant when talking about meat, and a travel agency when talking about flying all over the world. This is a way to show what you're talking about, and that adds an extra benefit to video over a textual profile or just a video with talking head. Making sure your research profile connects and that it visually and content-wise stands out by taking into account your target audience, next to how and where to share it, will be the content of our workshop. If you're interested, bring your ideas, and you're welcome to join us.